Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. Connor McKenzie here with our partner, Glade Pittenger. Apologize. Just now back online here at SNUathletics.com. Harding's going to be looking out for LB Willis and CJ Rodriguez. They tend to just be killing the Bison of Harding from their, with their sharp shooting, both shooting about 45-46% for three-point land, as Harding will be struggling tonight down on the post as Andres Cavas, 6'10", 235 senior, is out for the rest of the season. He's only played in 8 games this season. But they got some formidable posts there for Harding. So players like Noah Starkey and C.J. White and Huckel are going to have some problems there down low. They look to take advantage there, get to the line, and get foul calls. Here your starting lineup here for your SNU Crimson Storm. The starting lineup for the Crimson Storm. 6'1 junior out of Plano, Texas, number 3, Deshaun Portley. Junior out of Dallas, Texas, number 10, LB Willis, the Iceman. At guard, a 6'2 senior out of Harker Heights, Texas, number 13, CJ Rodriguez. CJ White, the 6'5, 235 junior transfer. And Anton Kankenpaw, 6'5, 188 junior out of Finland. Stormer coached by Adam Bobahosh, his 8th season here at SNU. So, Glay, what are we looking for here tonight as SNU goes up against one of the top teams in the conference in Harding?
I think they got to come. I think their offense is going to be there like it usually is, but if they get a big lead like they have in the past, they got to just continue to play defense, and they got to limit the turnovers as well and hopefully just hold on to a lead and get a really key win tonight.
Absolutely. SNU has shown to be able to commit some turnovers down the stretch late in the second half that can be horrible to the team. So look to discontinue that trend here. C.J. Rodriguez looks to light him up from outside and make him pay. C.J. White on the tip against number 50, Braden Eagleston, 6'6". Freshman out of Amarillo, Texas. Tip is controlled by the Storm. Storm looking to whip the ball around, penetrate his defense. Oh, the Bison, he got a quick foul. 11 seconds into the ball game, Braden Eagleston, his first. Team's first. And Tom Kankenpaw giving over to CJ Rodriguez. Rodriguez gets bumped and fouled on the drive by number 23, Blake McNair. It's McNair, Eagleston, Will Francis, Jacob Gibson, and Reggie Anthony on the floor for the Bison already with 2 quick fouls. C.J. White going in the post against Eagleston, muscles his way up. He's called for the travel call on the reverse prior to the shot. No good. Rodriguez looking to apply a little full court pressure here. Ball goes over the head of Anthony. Advancing up the floor, checked by Portley. Eagleston on the drive. Gets fouled on the way up by White. He pleads his case for straight up, but no call. No good if the call goes against White. His first, team first. Be free throws for Eagleston. Eagleston's first free throw rattles around the rim for about a day and a half and drops in. Eagleston receives the ball, sets his feet, fires, and good. Coach Bohosh yelling out the play for his team to execute, looking to get a bucket here on their second possession. Willis driving. Flips over to Kankenpaw. Kankenpaw drives. No good. We got a charging call on Anton Kankenpaw. Eagleston sliding his feet over, taking the charge. Looked like Kankenpaw was on the way up, Glade, on that call.
Yeah, Harding just got there a step early and was able to draw that charge.
I'm not sure about the call. We're going the other way here. Blake McNair going to fire a three off the rim. No good. Deshaun Portley up pushing. Deshaun Portley driving. Kicks it out to Willis. Willis driving. Sidesteps to Rod. To AK. Just whipping the ball around. Good defense by Harding. Not giving up any easy shots. C.J. White forces up the layup and good.
C.J. White's got a really soft touch around the rim. Once again, he's been able to prove it.
C.J. Rodriguez, a force to be reckoned with. Undersized at 6'5", but he plays like he's about 7'5". He's able to force up some tough shots. Jacob Gibson, the 6'5 senior, able to drive in and score on the lay-in. Rodriguez looking to feed White. His third time against Eagleston. He gets by him again. Layup is good. Good-looking crowd here for the Storm students. Letting the referees have. This should have been an and-one call. Harden driving. Nair holding. Anthony trying to find Eagleston in the post against White, but White is not having it. Three by Gibson is no good. Back to the way the other Storm. Tie ball game. Sean Portley for three. No good. Just off the back of the rim. He's had a little struggle shooting here, getting back into the rhythm after coming back from an off-season injury.
Yeah, but one guy that's really stood out so far in just the first few minutes is C.J. White.
Ooh, Jacob Gibson buries the tough jumper over two hands by the Storm defenders. LB calling out the play. LB gets a good scream by White. LB to Rodriguez for three. Yes, sir! Look at continue the trend from the girls' game before. C.J. Rodriguez for three. Storm takes their first lead out of the ballgame. There's a man you can't leave open on the Storm. It is definitely C.J. Rodriguez. He will burn you. Good defense there by AK. Forced the ball to go out of bounds off Gibson.
Yeah. Rodriguez is a much improved player from his junior to his senior year. He's also transferred from Northern Oklahoma College in Tonkawa.
C.J. White going to take a quick breather here. Sending in Noah Starkey, younger brother Jared Starkey, who's out for the season. Looking to recuperate. We hope he gets back on the floor real soon. Quinlan Newton also not in action tonight. Bison, a little miscommunication there between it's like McNair and Gibson. Going back the other way for the Storm. Rodriguez gets a good screen from Starkey. He's trying to whip the ball around and penetrate this defense at Harding. He got a foul down underneath the basket away from the ball. And I'll go against Stefan Andlakovic, the 6'8 junior out of Serbia. LB trying to find somebody. He's got Portley. Portley driving. No shot for LB. He's trying to drive in against these long defenders of Harding, but he gets the ball poked away. That'll be off Harding. Stay here with the Storm with 21 seconds left on the shot clock.
They caught a break right there. It looks like LB Wilson is the one that threw it out.
LB driving. Gives over to Starkey. Starkey to Portley. Portley with a nice drive there. Takes a shot. No good. Starkey fighting for the rebound. Stays away from the foul. Harding pushing. Got a what looked like a tip ball by LB Willis. Referee says no way. Going back the other way for the Storm.
SNU's got the lead right there. They got to continue and get on this. They got to continue the momentum and keep driving.
Noah Starkey trying to ask for the ball, but he gets denied again. AK with a step back jumper, no good. Rebound to McNair. To Francis. Good defense there by Noah Starkey. Taking a shot overhand, but win that any day. Rebound fought for by two Storm players. Rodriguez comes away with it. Rodriguez, good crossover drive. Takes the layup, and good.
Right now, both teams are kind of struggling to shoot the ball right. But like as Rodriguez was able to get the loose and get the lip right there.
You know, Starkey loses his man for a second, but gets back. LB Willis with the near steal there. McNair going to dribble out, try to get a good play call here. McNair going to take the three. Off the rim, no good. Nobody boxed out. The rebounder. Stefan Andelkovic gets his first shot up and good. Storm looking to pressure this Bison defense up 9-8. Portley finds AK to Willis. Willis with a nice stutter step drive. Starkey nearly gets the ball poked away from him. Willis is able to recover. Portley for three. Yes, sir! Hallelujah, it's raining threes for this Crimson Storm. Up 12-8 early on the Bison, the top team in the conference.
Sean Portley is another one of those guys you have to give a little bit of space because he is super quick. He was the all-time leading scorer at his junior college.
Here we go. Andelkovic for three. No good. AK with the rebound to Portley. Advancing, pushing. Portley starter step. Willis holding, looking for a screen from AK. He's going to take a three himself. No good. Harden looked to discontinue this trend by the Storm. They get fouled as they go underneath. That'll be the Storm's third team foul. Looks like we got a timeout on the floor. We'll take one with them. Duncan Wainwright, you're watching SNU basketball here at SNUAthletics.com. Here we go. Welcome back to SNUAthletics.com. Reggie Anthony on the free throw line. After Noah Starkey commits his first foul. Francisco Huckel and Garrett Butler into the ball game. C.J. White back in as well. Join Willis and Rodriguez. Anthony's first free throw is good. Storm students looking to distract Harding players at the free throw line, and it works here on the second attempt. It'll be Willis with the rebound. Storm holding. Good double screen there by Huckel and White to free up Rodriguez. He's trying to find Willis there on the backside lob, but no avail. Goes off Storm's hands. Back to Reggie Anthony's. Harding holding. Holding. Anthony trying to find McNair there for a three, but no good. Reggie Anthony on the back cut, open. Wide open there for a lay-in.
Cisco Huckel was trying to hedge on the ball screen, but he was just able to get loose.
Garrett Butler pleading his case that it was knocked out of his hands. which it was, but the referees see something else that we didn't, going back the other way. Francis driving against Francisco Huckel. Trying to find something here. Reggie Evans driving with no resistance. Garrett Butler called for the foul.
This Harding Bison team is really aggressive again into the hole. They're a very physical team.
A fourth team foul for the Storm. Sean Portley back into the ball game, giving L.B. Willis a break. Jacob Gibson trying to fight in the post against C.J. Rodriguez. No good. Going back the other way here. C.J. White looking to do some more work here against Eagleston. We got an offensive foul, it looks like, on the Storm. Not sure who it's on. Number 22, John Hudson, checking into the ball game. Giving Blake Will Francis, excuse me, a quick break. Storm looking to play a little more tough D here, up 12-11 with just over 12 minutes. A little more miscommunication there on the help side. Reggie Evans gets another cutting layup to the basket. I think the Storm are really trying to look into the post with C.J. White. He's got a great advantage over a lot of players that he goes against. C.J. Rodriguez with the drive to Huckel. Huckel for three. No good. Four Harding players crash the boards. McNair trying to shake Portley. Portley goes underneath the screen. Back to Eggleston. Gibson with a shot over Rodriguez, no good. I think it was partially blocked there. Rodriguez pushing, trying to find somebody. Butler for three. Don't leave him open. That's one of the few times you leave Garrett Butler open for three, and he doesn't hit. Reggie Evans with the uncontested free throw jumper, no good. Right, ball gets batted out of bounds off John Hudson. Like, we've got a media timeout here on the floor. We'll take one with them. Duncan Winter, where your Storm are up, or down, excuse me, 12-13. That is a quick change of pace here for the Bison. Watching SNU basketball here at SNUAthletics.com. Welcome back to SNUAthletics.com. Storm trying to get back into the lead here. They are down 12-13. Just under 11 minutes to go in this first half. Huckel driving. Has the free throw jumper wide open. No good. A little hesitation there may have altered that shot. Good close out there by C.J. White against Eggleston. Storm got to find some help there so these back cuts aren't open for Harding much longer, Glade.
I know, right?
Eggleston holding. Gibson, shot over AK, no good. White clears the rebound over everybody.
Right now, neither team has really found the rhythm. They're all getting some good looks, but no shots are really going in for either team right now. Let's see what happens in the next 30 minutes.
You're right, Glade. 5 of 13 shooting for the Storm, and 5 of 14 for the Bison. A near turnover there by the Storm. It goes off the hands of Reggie Anthony. Storm will have the ball with 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Francisco Huckel will take a break. Gibson out of the ball game as Blake McNair comes back in. Along with Zach Ward. Well, good spin move by Portley to shake and bake in his defenders. Deshaun Portley for a deep three. Yes, sir!
All the way downtown from Bricktown.
That's it. That shot was pretty much out from Bricktown, Glade. Another three for the Storm. They are now 3 for 7. Reggie Anthony able to get another lay-in.
That was like I said earlier, this Harding team is really physical. They're bumping out there, making sure they get layups. So
just some lapses in defense for the Storm. A little miscommunication as well. Rodriguez trying to find White down low. He does. Layup is good off the rim.
Man, he's got a really soft touch around that rim.
Storm take the lead back. 17-15, just over 9 minutes left in this half. Storm done a good job up until this point of limiting three-point shots. Up until that point, the Bison were just 0-4, now 1-5. John Hudson hits the first three of the game for the Bison. Meanwhile, the Storm are 3 for 7 from deep. Rodriguez driving. He's got a wide open lane. Up and good. And one.
And one. And a foul. Crimson Storm.
That's right, Glade. Another bucket for C.J. Rodriguez. He's up to 7 points overall. 3 of 3 shooting. With 2 boards, 3 assists, and a block. Doing a little bit of everything for his team here, trying to knock off the top team in the conference.
He's having a very consistent senior year. Like, he's hungry.
Absolutely. He just wants more. Just never wants to come off the court and always keep fighting for his teammates. Rodriguez completes a three-point play. Storm are up 20-18. Noah Starkey and Garrett Butler checking back in, giving C.J. White, Deshaun Portley a breather.
Coach Walsh has a lot of talent on his team, so he likes to do very quick rotations.
He does. Got to keep these players fresh, as this is a long up-and-down game. But shots just aren't falling, leading to more transition opportunities for both teams.
Excellent defense by Ken Kapaw.
Absolutely. Forced the air ball there by Harding. Zach Ward's three-point opportunity is no good. Rodriguez streaking, driving, gets the layup up and good. C.J. Rodriguez doing what he does best, torching the Harding Bison. 10 early points for Mr. Rodriguez.
Man, he's bringing some really good energy to the team today.
Absolutely. He's doing a fantastic job on the defensive offensive end. Rodriguez just hounding Darian McNair to shoot, and he does. We got a foul call on Antoine Burrell against Starkey. We're going back the other way in favor of the Storm.
Excellent fundamental basketball by the big man.
Most definitely. Noah Starkey doing a great job finding his man, getting a body on him, and just fighting for the rebound and letting the referee take care of the call. Coach Bohosh has got to be happy with his effort, his team's effort here so far. They're doing a great job against these great players of Harding on the board. It's Noah Starkey in the post. And one! Mr. Starkey, have yourself a game!
And one!
We got a timeout on the floor, ladies and gentlemen. I don't quite blame Coach for taking it. Don't go anywhere. You're watching SNU Basketball here at SNUAthletics.com. Hold on a sec. Let me.
I didn't hit it.
Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. Noah Starkey looking to complete the three-point play here. So you had a nice feed, CJ Rodriguez, for the layup. His free throw is up and good. So he completes the three-point play.
SNU's got a decent lead right here. They got to really play some defense right here. Defense wins games.
Absolutely. Coach Bowash definitely drilling into his guys to just keep active hands and just make these guys shoot over him. It's Noah Starkey forces the miss. We're going back the other way. Garrett Butler, one of the three, but he gets denied by Blake McNair. Just to update you on some scores here around the GAC in the women's games, Arkansas Monticello won 87-85 in a close battle against Southwestern Oklahoma State. The shot there is off the mark. Southern Arkansas and Northwest Oklahoma State just tipped off here. Southeastern Oklahoma State won 68-56 against Wichita Baptist. Southern Nazarene here, as you know, is up 25-18 late in the first half. Southwestern Oklahoma State is up 29-21 early in the first half. And Southern Arkansas up three late in the first half against Northwest Oklahoma State. As you saw earlier, Harding was able to defeat the Southern Nazarene Storm here earlier in our women's game, 82-60. Storm looking to discontinue that trend here in the Sorry Center. They're having a great game so far, up 25-18 with 7 minutes left to go in this half. Some great basketball that we're seeing here lately, Glade.
Yeah, it definitely is. It's been a really tight game so far. Both teams are just kind of starting to hit better. But
Noah Starkey going to work against Antoine Burrell. He gets called for the foul. He got his hand checked on the backside. That'll be Starkey's second personal foul. So he'll have to come out of the ball game. C.J. White checks back in. It'll be his 16th foul for the Storm. Harding here from our student section here. We got a great crowd out here tonight on both sides. Three-point attempts off the mark. Deshaun Portley clears with the rebound. Deshaun Portley to Rodriguez having a hot start here today with the pull-up jumper. Yes, sir!
He's got a little Kevin Durant in him.
I'm going to say it right here. That's nasty. C.J. Rodriguez is just on fire today. Starting off 5-for-5 and with 4 assists and 3 boards for his team. Great job today by the senior.
He's the heart and soul of this team.
Sean Portley hounding Jacob Gibson. Ball goes off Gibson's leg. Going back the other way for the Storm. Nursing a 9-point lead with just over 6 minutes left in this half. It's a great bat. It was off to a little bit of a rocky start here for the Storm. They started off just 5-of-13, but they've hit 6 of the last 7 shots. Storm whipping the ball around, looking to push this lead. C.J. White with a nice, nifty spin move, but ball goes off the front of the rim. Harding looking to push the other way. Will Francis looking to drive against C.J. Rodriguez. Rodriguez goes straight up. The ball goes off his hands, staying here with the Bison. Francisco Huckel in the ball game. Giving C.J. Rodriguez had a lion effort here tonight in this first half. Game with 12 points on 5-of-5 shooting. 3 assists, 4 assists, 3 boards, and 2 blocks. What more can you ask for one of your best players on the team? Huckel against Micah Bailey. Shot is no good. Storm wins that battle here and goes the other way for the Storm.
Coach Walsh really has to be happy with the team defense right now. He's just probably telling him every time he gets a chance, keep it up. We got to keep going.
Absolutely. One thing I've noticed here from the Storms, they're doing a great job on their closeouts, chopping their feet and calling ball and just yelling shot whenever shots go up and blocking out on the defensive end. They gave up a couple early layups to Reggie Anthony, but lately they've just been locked in. Anton Kangapa looking to get in the scoring matchup here. He finds LB Willis to Portley. Portley trying to drive free, but no good. He gets cut off. C.J. White going to work against Eggleston. The reverse layup. Oh, my goodness. C.J. White.
Nasty.
He jumped from outside the paint and did an up and under reverse. That was fantastic. Reggie Anthony looking to drive. He avoids the block there by Cisco Huckel. Lead is up back to 9 for the Storm. Sean Portley holding to Huckel. Huckel trying to feed White. No good. Good cutoff there by Will Francis. Sean Portley for 3. 3 for 3. Yes, sir.
Another 3.
Good grief. These guys are lighting it up here. Sean Portley, 3 of 3 from deep. Jacob Gibson looking to drive. Gets cut off at the baseline. LB Wells with the contest. Cisco Huckel gets the board. Trying to find somebody. Huckel to Willis. Willis to White. Feed the big man. He gives out to Portley. Looking to go 4 for 4. Oh, no good. Just rattles out. This place would have blown the roof off the place if he hits that. Timeout for Coach Jeff Morgan. He's seen enough. We'll take one with him. Don't go anywhere. You're watching SNU basketball here at SNUathletics.com. Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. It's been the CJ Show. If your name's CJ in this game, you are doing a fantastic job. CJ White and Rodriguez combined in 9 of 10 shots here. That's a good sign from two of your more experienced players here on the team. Sean Portley checking Reggie Anthony. Jacob Gibson trying to find something over Rodriguez. Hadn't had much luck. LB Willis clears the rebound. Good contest there by CJ White. Forcing the shot over the hand. It's usually a win for the defender. Rodriguez with the lob to Willis. Yes, sir! Oh, my goodness. That's nasty.
Something we have been waiting to see LB's entire career here at SNU. He finally got the alley-oop.
Absolutely. Great pass by CJ Rodriguez. Great play call by Coach Bohas. Jacob Gibson looking to quiet the crowd with that 3. No good. Cisco Huckel clears the rebound. LB Willis trying to find somebody. Ooh, CJ Rodriguez with a nice crossover. LB feeling it. No good. He gets his own rebound. Layup. Good. Around the rim. About after a day and a half on the rim.
16-point lead against the best team in the conference. Can't be much happier right now.
And holding them to 20 points through nearly 18 minutes. It's a good sign if you're Coach Bohotch. They got a foul call on Deshaun Portley is. Anthony was going up for the lay-in. I mean, on that lob, that was just something else, man. LB had enough time to hang up in the air, cock the ball back, and then throw it down. Great play.
A little Westbrook mode right there with the explosiveness.
Reggie Anthony with his first free throw. No good. AK Anton Kekapaw in for Cisco Huckel. Looking to get on the action. Probably get a lob of his own.
That last slam was brought to you by CJ Rodriguez.
Looks like we got a timeout on the floor. We'll take one with him. Don't go anywhere. You're watching SNU basketball here at SNUathletics.com. Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. Reggie Anthony preparing his second free throw. Anthony fires nothing but net. On the floor for your Crimson Storm, Willis, Kenkenpaul, Rodriguez, White, and Portley. LB Willis igniting Storm offense with the rest of his teammates with a fantastic lob pass from C.J. Rodriguez. Rodriguez takes another three. Yes, sir!
They don't get it. They don't realize you cannot leave him open.
I mean, he might as well be wearing a blindfold and start shooting because he's not missing. He's 6-for-6 for 15 quick points here in this first half. Gibson feeding to Eggleston with the pump fake. He gets poked away by Rodriguez. We're off and running. Rodriguez looking to cross over. Oh, shot just off the mark.
He was like, I want to take a little heat check right there. Let's see.
It's his first miss of the game. Now 6-of-7. Reggie Anthony driving in. It's bumped by Portley. Shot doesn't count. Two free throws for Mr. Anthony. Good shake and bake there by C.J. Rodriguez on the last possession. Will Francis just couldn't get his legs from under him to knock down the shot. Referees conferring. Foul call was on. That one's on Anton Kenkenpaul. That'll be his second foul of the ball game. Free throw will be 1-1 attempt. Off the mark. LB Willis clears the rebound. Excuse me, that foul was on Sean Portley, his second. Rodriguez calling out the play, resetting. Shot clock winding down, they got to find something. LB drives down, takes the long jumper over a hand, no good. Gibson to Anthony. Anthony trying to shake Portley, not going to happen. Gibson trying to get by Kenkenpaul. Kenkenpaul not giving much ground. Got a shoulder thrown in to Kenkenpaul, but foul called on Kenkenpaul for the block. Count the basket for Mr. Jacob Gibson. Storm up 16 with 1-on-1 left. In this first half, Kenkenpaul will take a seat with his second foul. C.J. White checks back in. C.J. White starting off 4-of-5 with 8 points and 4 rebounds. After starting off shooting around 38%, the Storm up to 53%, shooting 16 of 30 as Gibson completes a three-point play. Harding shooting 9 of 28 for 32%. Little full-court man press here by Harding. Storm able to get by it easily. Half-court trap there almost caught Willis by surprise. Able to get it out of it and work the offense. Storm could go 2-for-1 here if they're quick. They're getting cut off by these Harding defenders. Rodriguez fires up for the deep two. Nearly gets another three-point play. He'll go to the line for two shots. C.J. Rodriguez, 1-for-1 at the line. 6-of-7 overall and 2-of-3 from three-point land. First free throw is good for Mr. Rodriguez. Rodriguez receives the ball, does his little ritual, rises, fires, and good. Substitution for the Storm. Garrett Butler in for Deshaun Portley. Garrett Butler 0-for-2 on his only two free throw attempts. Looking to possibly get one more shot here before the half ends. Reggie Anthony's going to have something to do with that. He drives in. Reggie Anthony having himself quite a game. 12 points already on 5-of-6 shooting. LB trying to work the ball around. 15 seconds left, trying to work the ball for the last shot. Increase his lead to 17, probably 18. CJ gets a good screen from Mr. CJ White. Out to Garrett Butler for three. No good. CJ White runs over Jacob Gibson and gets called for the foul. 1 second left in the half. Storm got to play solid defense after these. Jacob Gibson's going to the line as that is the 10th team foul for the Storm. Jacob Gibson looking to cut into this lead here at the end of the half.
Shot didn't go in, but you could not ask for a better look right there than they just got.
That's right. It was a great pass there by Rodriguez, able to penetrate the defense. Gibson's first free throw is no good. Noah Starkey back in for the Storm. Gibson's second free throw is good. LB launches a prayer shot. That goes to be no good. Pretty much through a Hail Mary pass to our referee. Storm take a 41-27 lead going into halftime. When we come back, we'll have a quick breakdown of what happened in the first half and then a sideline report from our man Glade Pittenger with head coach Adam Bohosh. Don't go anywhere. You're watching SNU basketball here at SNUathletics.com. Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. Connor McKenzie here with my partner, Glade Pinscher. Glade, what are some things that stuck out to you in this first half as SNU is up 41-27?
Well, first off, SNU shot the ball really well, shooting 51% from the floor and 38% from three, 4-4 on free throws. They really kept Harding in check, making them only shoot 34%. 1-12 from the three-point line, so they're only shooting 8% from three, and they're only shooting 60% from the line. So their defense is being really good while their offense is strong as well.
Absolutely. SNU is definitely holding their own. They're playing a lot better than the last time these two teams met. And when they did, Storm lost 86-57. The shots just weren't falling for them. But that's definitely not the case for today. Who are some players that stuck out to you in this first half for SNU?
Once again, CJ Rodriguez really stood out tonight. That's sitting out tonight. He's got 17 points. Then Sean Portley's got 3 of 5 from the 3, 9 points on 60% shooting. Then C.J. White's got 8 points shooting 80%, so he's having a strong game as well, and they're getting it done as a team.
Absolutely, definitely distributing the ball here. They had 7 assists on 16 made baskets, so they're having a great job distributing the ball. And C.J. Rodriguez, as you say, was just going off. Started off 5 for 5, and actually 6 for 6, and had 4 assists and 3 rebounds. So he's definitely making an impact. On the flip side there for Harding, Reggie Anthony is just being able to drive to the paint seemingly whenever. There needs to be a little more help resistance there from SMU's post players such as C.J. White or Noah Starkey and so on and so forth. For Harding as well, Jacob Gibson's able to just penetrate and give these people problems here for SMU, but they're holding Harding to 27 points in the first half. I think Coach Boha should be very happy with those results. What do you expect to go forward in this second half?
Well, they got a 14-point lead right now, but they cannot be satisfied because Harding's number one in the conference for a reason, so they're going to look for a way to come back. So we got to keep fighting on defense and keep getting the looks we've gotten.
I think you're right, Glade. We look forward to see how this second half goes underway. Don't go anywhere. When we come back, we'll have our man Glade Pittenger down with head coach Adam Bohosh get his keys to the game, what he looks forward to for his team. This is SMUathletics.com. One.
Welcome back. Welcome back to SNUAthletics.com. Good to send to our man, Clayton Pitcher, with Coach Bohatch. Clayton.
Turnover battle. Only five. Talk about how that goes in the second half.
We did a good job of taking care of the ball from the first half.
Yeah, we got to the line, got to the rim a few times, and shot it well there.
Thank you, Coach. Back to you guys.
All right, thanks. Looks like the second half underway. Watching us here at athletics.com.
Welcome back to SNUAthletics.com. Second half just now underway, and the Storm nearly get a turnover here on the first play of the game. Lob to LB Willis. Yes, sir!
He's got some firepower in him tonight.
LB Willis climbing the stairs on that one. Good contest there by LB. Rebound put back to Eggleston is no good. Storm going back the other way. Good start to this half. Getting a couple pass flicks. Going back the other way for the slam. Sean Portley driving. Anton Kegenpaw feeds it to White. White trying to spin baseline again. There all day. Just rims out again. C.J. White. Francis driving. Anthony. Anthony with a shot over. Sean Portley is good. Lead back to 14. Storm with some great defense here. A lot of these shots here glided in the second half, in the first half actually. Went over a hand, and that's part in why Harding hasn't been able to connect.
Yeah, SNU's playing great defense right now. Coach Bosch has to be very pleased.
I would say so. His team's doing a great job on both ends of the floor. Storm got to get a shot. About 3 seconds left. LB Willis gets pushed out of bounds by Will Francis. Will Francis, 6'5", 210 junior out of Searcy, Arkansas. Actually went to Harding Academy, so he was primed and prepped to come here at Harding University. With the foul, it's a fresh shot clock. LB Willis going to take a three and gets fouled on the way up by number 50, Braden Eggleston. That'll be three free throws up and coming for Mr. LB Willis. That'll be the, I believe, second foul, yes, on Braden Eggleston. He looked to keep him out of foul trouble if you're the Bison. LB Willis, second free throw. Nothing but net again. Eggleston fouled the wrong guy. But then again, when the Storm players are lighting up from three-point range, got to contest, and occasionally you'll get called for the foul. Willis' third free throw is no good. Henley tracks down his own rebound. Reggie Anthony looking to push the ball up the floor here. He cut into this lead. Storm looked to just be playing Glade determined defense to get turnovers and stops here. What do you think?
Yeah, that definitely just kind of like that stop right there. They got to keep doing that.
Rodriguez pushing against Francis. Rodriguez with the incredible up and under play. Count the basket and one for Mr. Rodriguez.
I'm surprised he hasn't flexed that off with as strong as that was.
Absolutely. He's just able to just power his way up there, take the contact, and finish.
He can take a hit. He is not scared of anything.
C.J. White getting our boy Big Tony mop up the sweat there. Keep the court clear. Safe from injury. Big Tony, the team manager. We're our SNU basketball team. C.J. Rodriguez receives the ball. Does his ritual. Sets. Fires. Nothing but net. Completes a three-point play. Lead now up to 19 for the Storm. Looking good so far in this first half, Glade.
Yeah, Harding is really doing poor without their big man.
Will Francis is able to drive in easily and kiss it off the glass for two. C.J. Rodriguez again having a great game. 7 of 8 shooting for 20 points, 6 assists, and 3 boards.
Another 3.
Sean Portley, 4 for 6 from 3-point land, having a great game here tonight. Will Francis feeling it. He's going to drop it from Steph Curry range.
Yeah, he shot that down from the panhandle.
LB Willis looking to drive in. He gets called for the charge easily. Braden Eggleston was standing there for quite some time just waiting for LB Willis to escalate and run right into him.
He must have thought he was going to pull a Vince Carter and jump over him and dunk the ball.
No, that would have been quite a sight to see, Clay. Will Francis driving out, kicks it out to Jacob Gibson for three. Yes, sir. Not what you want to see here. They hit a couple shots. They can make a run and get this game back interesting. There's now a 14-point lead.
Made or miss. Must get a stop right here so they don't get any momentum going.
LB Willis driving, takes the corner jumper. Yes, sir. Good hands there by C.J. White and awareness of the crowd, seeing they had a big man running right towards him.
Way to hurry back and deflect it.
That's right. C.J. White having a great game. 8.6 boards on 4-6 shooting. Noah Starkey back in the ball game. In his first action here in this second half. Rodriguez able to alter Will Francis' shot. Francis gets the ball back. Count the basket and one for Mr. Francis. That foul is on C.J. Rodriguez, his second. Will Francis seems to be playing determined basketball here. Will Francis, he's the man out of Harding Academy. The junior just trying to take over for his team here. And he completes the three-point play. Old Francis now up to 3 of 5 shooting for a total of 8 points now. Sean Portley getting trapped in the corner, finds LB. Able to clear out to Rodriguez, reset. AK on the wing, trying to feed Starkey. Starkey to Rodriguez, had him open in the corner, but the ball just goes off his hands. Rodriguez coming back in frustration, trying to get his team to work together here.
Got to get a stop right here. They got a little momentum going. They got to stop it.
That's right. Possession by possession, Will Francis, one way or another, is looking to take over this team. Reggie Anthony is able to find a cutting. Stefan Andelkovic. The lead is down to 11, once at 19. They'll be able to drive down. He's got hands all over him, and a kick ball violation on Will Francis. Stay here with the Storm. Francisco Hugo will be back in when we come back. We got a timeout on the floor. Duncan Winterware, you're watching SNU basketball here at SNUathletics.com. Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. Just want to update you on some scores around the GAC. In the men's game, Southern Arkansas in a battle with Northwestern Oklahoma State. Just under 16 minutes left. It's a four-point game, 36-32 in favor of Southern Arkansas. Wichita Baptist up by 4 against Southeastern with 17 minutes left to go in that game. A tight battle, about like this one, with Southwestern Oklahoma State and Arkansas Monticello. 12-point game. C.J. Rodriguez casts another three. Up to 23 points on 7 of 8 shooting.
C.J. Rodriguez is really putting up playing like he wants the All-American this year.
Absolutely. And Will Francis with the answer on the easy lay-in. Lead back to 11 for the Storm. Sean Portley holding. Finding LB trying to drive. Gets a good screen from Starkey. Rodriguez driving. Going in a big Steve Nash circle around the baseline. LB Willis trying to shake Francis. He does from a good screen from Starkey. Shot off the rim and in. Yes, sir. LB Willis has just come alive here. In this second half, he's now up to 14 points on 6 of 10 shooting. Will Francis is going to take a deep three. Off the rim, no good. Rebound to Starkey. LB, screen from Francisco Huckel. Another screen from Starkey. Sean Portley driving, trying to find somebody. Throws it off the rim. Finds Willis. Rodriguez in the corner driving. Sidesteps the defender. Got to find somebody. Shot clock's winding down. Sean Portley takes care of himself.
Him and Rodriguez are really bringing it tonight.
Absolutely. They're keeping the ball on a string. Like you said earlier, the turnovers are limited. They just got to prevent these easy drives here by Will Francis. He just dumps it off to Andelkovic again for the lay-in.
Harding is not giving up.
Garrett Butler and Anton Kankapaw set to check back in. LB Willis over to Starkey. Starkey with the lay-in. Good.
Get a stop right here.
That would be huge. Probably cut the ties here with Harding. Will Francis being checked by Huckel. He's driving. Reggie Anthony left wide open for three. Doesn't take it, but he gets bumped by Portley on the drive. That'll be a third team foul for the Storm. It'll be his third personal. Garrett Butler and AK checking into the ball game. giving Huckel and Portley a break. Portley in foul trouble. Anyways, that's probably for the best there. Good move here by Bohosh. Doing quick, frequent substitutions, keeping his players fresh in case this game gets close down the stretch.
Yeah, and he's definitely got the weapons for it.
And a coach for three, no good. Rebound to LB Willis. He gets called for the push-off on Mr. John Hudson. SMU students are hearing it from the referees here. There, I guess they're chanting tic-tac refs. They're on these touchy calls. Will Francis going against Rodriguez. He throws a layup, no good. I think it was blocked there by CJ.
That was a good stop.
LB flips over to Butler for three. No good. Back tap by CJ White to get a fresh shot clock. Storm up 62-46 with 13 minutes left. LB trying to shake. Gibson, he sidesteps him. Crazy crossover. He misses the layup, and Rodriguez again with the rebound. So I'm looking to settle down here, work the offense, and go to good shot. Willis trying to shake Gibson. He's just got him on skates. C.J. White down in the post against Andrukovic. He gets called for the travel call. I don't know about that one.
It looks like he took a dribble before he took any steps, so I do not know about that call.
It looks like it, Glade. His pivot foot may have just slid out from under him as he was driving down, but nevertheless, we're going back the other way. Jacob Gibson going to take a three over AK. Yes, sir. Not sure what else you can do if you're Anton Kegenpaw. He had a great closeout on the shot. He just was able to knock it down. Sometimes good offense beats good defense. We got an illegal screen on C.J. White. He does not agree at all with the call. We're going back the other way. That'll be his third personal, fifth team. L.B. Willis going to take a seat with Deshaun Portley back in the game. C.J. White's got to take a breather here with three fouls. Can't afford to get a fourth. So Noah Starkey back into the game.
Think about this team for SMU this year compared to last year. They have a lot more size. They were a quick team last year, but they didn't have a lot of guys to compete inside, but now they have a lot of those people.
Will Francis on the drive. Feels he got bumped, but no foul. Ball goes the other way off Jake Gibson's hands. And this is what the Storm are looking for here. Get some turnovers. Make Harding pay. When they get the ball out, that's now seven turnovers here for Harding. Got another foul underneath. Another charging call here taken by John Hudson. That'll be the fourth foul for Deshaun Portley. We got a timeout on the floor. We'll take it with him. Don't go anywhere. You're watching SNU basketball here at SNUathletics.com. Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. Storm with a 13-point lead to Just under 12 minutes here to go. Jacob Gibson driving against Anton Kangapaw. His shot is no good. Rebound fought for by three Storm players to C.J. Rodriguez. Be Rodriguez's fourth rebound. Anton trying to drive against Hudson, no good. Rodriguez driving against Dawson Yates, getting his first action of the game. He gets called for the bump against Rodriguez. That'll be his first personal team foul, fourth. Storm offense has kind of lagged here a little bit these last couple minutes after igniting. For now, 21 points in just under 9 minutes to play in the second half. Willis holding, trying to find somebody. Plenty of time on the shot clock to get a good shot and work this through this offense. Starkey in the post. Yes, sir. Oh, excuse me. No, he got a little ahead of himself there. Ball just rattled out, but he gets the ball back. And there'll be more free throws.
Almost
no Starkey.
Almost just had a face-up dunk on the guy. That would have been really nasty.
Oh, yeah, this place would have blown the roof off the place if he completed that play. I guess they're calling the foul on the floor before Starkey went up, so just a common foul on the inbound.
And Noah Starkey is a really big guy. It's hard to hold him.
Anton Kankapaw. It's body checked by John Hudson. Excuse me, Dawson Yates. It'll be his second, team sixth. And try the inbound again with the fresh shot clock. Coach Bohosh conferring with the official, possibly about why there's no free throws. Now Starkey. Catch the inbound to L.B. Willis and Antoine Burrell. He's called for the block against L.B. as he's trying to catch the inbound from Starkey. So odd foul calls here as L.B. Willis to the line for two. I believe it's 1-1. That's correct. Be seven fouls here for the Bison. Willis sets his feet, fires. Yes, sir. LB up to now 13 points here. Has just erupted here in this second half. John Hudson out of the ball game. Back in Blake McNair. The 6'4 senior out of Harrison, Arkansas. Looking to make a difference here and help his buddy Will Francis back into this game. Second free throw is good for LB. Dawson Yates. Pushing the ball up the floor. This is where the Storm here can get caught. If they let Harding take a couple deep shots and they hit him, this is a whole new ball game. Good block there by AK.
But he got around that screen right there and was able to block a great defense by AK.
Absolutely, but there was a foul call, I believe, on Mr. Rodriguez on a loose ball foul. So that'll be his third. Team seventh, 1-1 fouls for Mr. Will Francis. Will Francis taking his second free throw of the game, and it is good. Will Francis had a little streak going there for the Bison, driving in and hitting a three. He's up to 11 points on 4-9 shooting. Make that 12. Got four rebounds to go with four assists. A lot of balance going here for the Bison. Reggie Anthony, who we haven't heard a lot of here in this second half, 14 points on 6-7 shooting. Not even in the ballgame right now. Hukul holding, trying to find somebody. Drives into the paint against McNair. Gets a layup. Good. Cisco Hukul up to 4 points now for the Storm. Good closeout there on Francis. Francis trying to beg for a call, not going to get it. Starkey against Burrell. Starkey straight up against Burrell, forces the shot up and good.
That was good defense. He made him take a tough shot. It was just a great touch.
Absolutely. And LB Willis gets the ball taken from down low. Nearly tackles Dawson Yates. He calls a timeout. We'll take one with him. Don't go anywhere. You're watching SNU Basketball here at SNUAthletics.com. Welcome back to SNUAthletics.com. After the turnover by LB Willis, Dawson Yates able to force that turnover and call a timeout for the Bison. On the floor for the Storm, it's Willis, Huckel, Butler, Kankenpaw, and Starkey. It's the counter of Francis, McNair, Yates, Burrell, and Gibson. Burrell holding against Starkey, flips it out to Gibson. Gibson trying to find it back to Burrell. He does. Starkey able to get scored over by the smaller but lengthy Antoine Burrell. Storm nursing an 11-point lead as it was back up to 15. Now back to 11. Huckel for three. No good. The bank was not open for Mr. Huckel today. Yates to Francis for three. No good off the rim. LB Willis with the rebound, but he gets fouled. Fighting for it. Should be more free throws for Mr. Willis. That foul is on Blake McNair, his third. Blake McNair not having a great shooting day today. He's 0 of 6 overall, 0 of 5 from 3. He does have 5 rebounds and 2 assists. Jacob Gibson having a nice day for himself as well. 5 of 13 shooting, 2 of 5 from 3 and 14 points. Okay. First free throw's off the mark. Back the other way. Good defense there by Garrett Butler to tip the pass. Prevent a transition bucket potentially by the Bison. Clay, what's something you're noticing out here in this second half as going underway? We're seeing a lot of turnovers. What do you think's been going on?
I think both teams are kind of just – both teams are bringing the pressure right now, so they're kind of struggling to fight through it. But overall, I think SNU's defense has been pretty solid, and that's why they're still in the lead.
I think you're right. They're having – a great advantage there. The jump shots are just not falling for Harding overall. 21 of 52 so far. They only have 2 turnovers in the second half to the Storm 6, so definitely getting after it. Make that 7 here for the Bison. Dawson Yates dribbling up. He's got numbers. He finds Francis. Francis to Burrell to McNair, but shot is no good. We got a foul call underneath. Rodriguez called for his 4th foul. And he's telling his coach, keep him in. He's going to play harder. Nevertheless, he's got to come out with 4. Garrett Butler and C.J. White in the ball game.
I haven't seen Deshaun Portley in a long while.
And Deshaun Portley been struggling with foul game as well with 4. Other foul trouble, C.J. White's got 3, LB Willis with 2, Anton Kankenpaw with 2, and Noah Starkey with 2. So some of your key players are struggling with the foul calls.
Now without Rodriguez and without Portland, some other people have to step up now.
Absolutely. Coach Bohar's looking to more his experienced guys to knock down some shots and play some tough D. Timeout on the floor. We'll take it with him. Don't go anywhere. You're watching SNU Basketball here at SNUAthletics.com. Welcome back to SNUAthletics.com. Stone holding on to a 9-point lead now. What was 19 earlier in this half? Ignited by a couple exciting plays of LB Willis and Sean Port. Stone trying to get the ball across in this man press here in this trap. Anton Kengapal left open for three, doesn't take it. Stone now work through the offense, trying to milk some clock here and score some buckets down the stretch. LB finds Butler. Butler driving. LB thought the pass from Butler was going into the corner. Nevertheless, it's a turnover. Back to the Bison. See, the Storm kind of getting to these trends here. Good up and under by Will Francis. And Cisco Hugel is now 16 points on 5 of 11 shooting.
Got to really take care of the ball from here and get some key stubs. It's only a 7-point game.
The Storm here have a problem of turning the ball over. These odd stretches in the second half. Could be fatigue setting in. LB has played most of this game here. Haven't looked at C.J. White in this second half, really. Cisco Hugo gets called for the double dribble. I'm not sure about that one. He lost control of the ball when it was passed to him and they tried dribbling, but nonetheless, we're going back the other way. Apologize for the score there, ladies and gentlemen. The score is 66-59, not 57, in favor of the Storm. Now, there we go. Just over 7 minutes left here in this ball game. Storm here trying to control Will Francis. Anton Kegapod clears the rebound to LB. LB driving, trying to shake Dawson Yates. This doesn't work. LB to White. Haven't seen much of him lately. There he is, C.J. White. I think that's what you got to go to. C.J. White in the post is your bread and butter. You got to feed the big man.
Sean Portley's coming back in the game as he's got at least 12 points for tonight.
That's right. Sean Portley with 14 for the game. Will Francis was feeling it. The rim wasn't feeling him. His shot is off the mark. Storm take back the ball. I think if you're SNU, you got to keep trying to drive into the paint and not turn the ball over right here. We got a steal here. Anton Burrell is going to take care of the rest. Coach Bohosh not looking to take a timeout here. We're going to keep it right here at SNUAthletics.com. This is a problem that SNU kind of gets into. They'll turn the ball over late when they got a slight lead. What do you think they got to do down the stretch here?
From here, they just got to kind of, unless they can go somewhere with, like, to increase a passing angle or get to the hole, they should probably hold on to the ball as much as they can, but not waste too much time so they can get a good shot.
I think there's more Also, on top of what you were saying, they're just telegraphing their passes a little bit, and they're getting a little stagnant. The ball just kind of sticking in LB's hands. They just got to get some more ball movement and look to get their guys some more open shots. I look forward to them trying to feed C.J. White in the post. He's a manimal down there in the post. They got to keep feeding him. What do you think?
Yeah, he's definitely killing it today. But Deshaun Bortley, he's coming back in the game, so he'll add a little more spark to what they need.
That's true. Deshaun Bortley, 5 of 8 shooting here for the day. 4 of 6 from 3. But he's got 4 fouls, along with C.J. Rodriguez sitting on the bench with 4 fouls as well. Coach Bohaj got to keep him there to utilize him down the stretch before he picks up a 5th.
Yeah, sorry. Hopefully he doesn't come back in and get a foul. Oh, because that's the last thing they need right now.
Absolutely. The leader of this offense with 23 points on 8 of 9 shooting. 4-4 from the line. 5 rebounds, 7 assists, 3 steals, 2 blocks, and only 2 turnovers. I don't know what else you can ask for from your senior here leading this team.
Yeah, he has turned into quite the player.
As you said, Deshaun Porter back in the game along with C.J. Rodriguez to join Willis, Kenkapaw, and White.
Both of them have kind of had to lay off and let their men get the shots before they foul again.
They got to be real smart and not take too many chances whipping the ball around. Deshaun Porter trying to find White in the post. He's not there. Shot clock winding down. C.J.'s going to drive. Flips a layup. No good. But he gets fouled on the way up. Good heads-up play there by C.J. Rodriguez. Seeing the shot clock winded down, having the awareness to drive down and get the bucket and the foul. No bucket, just the foul. Rodriguez's first free throw is no good. I'm not sure why he wasn't given 2 free throws there as he was driving. He must have called it on the floor before the shot went up.
Bison's only down 7. They've really come back, so they got to play hard right here.
Milkovich with the layup, no good. White with the rebound. Willis trying to get past the defense. He gets fouled in doing so. He'll go back to the line.
That puts him in the double bonus right here.
You're right. Glad there'll be 2 free throws the rest of the way for the Storm. LB Willis, a nice day out there, 5-10 shooting, 5 boards, 2 assists. No steals today, but he gets his first free throw to go as he's now up to 15 points in the game. Cisco Huckel back in the ball game, giving Rodriguez a breather, a little offense to defense. Change of pace. Reggie Anthony, haven't hardly seen him in this second half. I'm not sure why. Oh, LB Willis with the ferocious block.
Not in my house, and that's what he said.
Blake McNair, do not come in LB's house. You are not welcome here.
This is my court. This is my paint. I'm protecting it. That's what LB says.
That's exactly it. Andelkovich for 3. Yes, sir.
But they get rewarded for it as they get an extra point.
Sean Portley trying to find someone trapped in the corner, but he gets fouled by Will Francis.
And one guy we haven't seen all night is D'Artagnan Meggs, who's been getting several minutes lately and doing quite well.
You're right. His minutes have been diminished here. The senior out of Lake Elsinore, California. Coach Bohaj looking to try some new things, giving Anton Kengapal more minutes here. Sean Portley with his first free throw. It's up and good. His first free throw of the game, in fact. Sean Portley's second free throw is good. Lead back up to 8. Just under 5 minutes here to go. It's crunch time. Jacob Gibson trying to drive against Kenkapaw. Drives in. The blocking foul and 1. Mr. Gibson.
That did not look like a good call at all. Looks like
I don't believe so. He seemed pretty set in concrete down there taking that charge. Nonetheless, the referees are sticking with what they called. Kenkepaw gets called for his third foul. Rodriguez in for Kenkepaw. Just an awful call down there.
I'd be very frustrated myself.
Jacob Gibson on the free throw line. 6 of 14 shooting for 16 points. For the senior, he gets the free throw to go. The ball don't lie, he made his free throw.
Harding's really bringing a little pressure now.
Good pass there by Poyley getting it out. Rodriguez finds White, but he gets the ball taken by Reggie Anthony. No call. Going back the other way. Sean Poyley closing down on Jake Gibson for three. Yes, sir. Just like that, it is a two-point game. Just over 4 minutes left here.
Got to play smart right here. Can't force anything.
Sean Poyley's got to keep his composure here. If I'm him, I'll get the ball to LB or CJ's hands to close out this game. Bison down by as much as 19. Warren back to two. Portley to White. White against Kovic. Yes, sir.
Oh, man, the clutch play, that is exactly what SNU needed.
Like I said, the bread and butter, you got to feed the big man. C.J. White coming big through for his team down the stretch. Storm here got to get a couple stops. Andrew Kovic going against White, power against power. C.J. White straight up, the bucket is good, back to a two-point game.
Three and a half minutes left, up two.
Just over 3 minutes left here. Shot clock with about 15. Got enough time to find a good shot. No need to rush. Ooh. A good look there by White, but the ball just goes off the hands of LB Willis. Timeout on the floor. We'll take it with them. Don't go anywhere, folks. We got a barn burner here at SNU Athletics. com. Welcome back to SNUAthletics.com. Storm holding on to a 74-72 lead. Just turned the ball over before this timeout here. Story in the second half, the Crimson Storm have turned it over 12 times in the second half, whereas just two for Harding. Harding has definitely made the Storm pay 25 points off 12 turnovers. That's over 1 point for every turnover they've gotten. That's actually over two points for every turnover the Storm committed in this second half. Can't have it.
Unless you get back on defense and get a stop every time, turnovers will really come back to haunt you.
These officials and Harding players are really hearing it from these Storm students. Reggie Anthony being checked by Portley. Bison just whipping the ball around. Trying to find Jake Gibson for three. He's going to take it over a hand. Yes, sir. My goodness.
Talk about a tough shot. There's just not much you can do about that, as it was well contested.
Jacob Gibson, have yourself a game. It's their first lead in quite some time. C.J. Rodriguez in the corner for three. Yes, sir! Rodriguez, a pretty good shooter in his own right. Cha-ching, a Storm money ball. And here we go. Just 2.5 minutes left in the ball game. Jake Gibbs going to take another three. No, sir.
It was a good contest. The same contest as last time. This time, just a knockout. Great defense by the guy from Finland.
Sometimes great defense gets beat by better offense, and this time defense won. Rodriguez driving low. Avoids the charge. Can't get Paul for three. Yes, sir! Lead it back up to five with 2 minutes left in this game.
Great dude. That was a great defense position and offensive possession by Kankapaw.
Good steal by Deshaun Portley, and we're running. Portley getting hounded by Jacob Gibson. No call. Not sure what's going on here. Rodriguez holding, being checked by Anthony. Rodriguez holding. Rodriguez finds Kankapaw in the corner. He's going to take down a three. Instead, he'll take a long two. No good. Rebound almost to the Storm. Back to Andelkovich.
Wasn't a bad look at all.
Reggie Anthony calling out the play, trying to find a good look. Will Francis, haven't heard from him in a while. Jake Gibson for three over Anton Kengapaw. No, sir. Sean Portley hangs on to the rebound. He'll give it off to his buddy LB Willis, racing up the floor. We got a foul call with 1:21 left. LB on the free throw line for two.
Much needed free throws right here.
SNU has come alive in these last 3 minutes, just unloading on the Bison defenders, giving it back to them from three. Jacob Gibson has just exploded in this second half with 23 points total. LB's first free throw is up and good. As I was saying, Jacob Gibson, 4 of 9. A lot of his shots are coming overhand. There's not much that these players can do. Anton Kankapaw, a long defender, that's tough to beat. LB for his second free throw. Up and good. Lead is up to 7 now. 1:21 left.
SNU did lose the lead, but they did not panic.
Sean Portley with the near steal off Anthony. Anthony's going to take the lay-in. CJ Rodriguez can't afford a fifth foul. Storm trying to get the ball across, and they do easily. Sean Portley taking the ball up. Finds Rodriguez in the corner. Seconds left in this ball game. Storm up 5 with the ball and the possession arrow if there's a jump ball. Rodriguez calling out the play, getting the screen from Kankapaw. Rodriguez firing a three. Oh, come on! Come on! Can't stop that.
He's all fired up down there.
CJ Rodriguez is in the zone. This Storm crowd has come alive. They're hearing it great from their senior, CJ Rodriguez. 10 of 11 overall, 5 of 6 from 3. 5 rebounds, 8 assists for 29 points overall. What more can you ask for from CJ Rodriguez?
There's absolutely nothing more you can ask. He has made some very clutch plays down the stretch.
Coach is fired up. The crowd's fired up. Heck, I'm fired up. We got to take a timeout. We'll be right back here at SNUathletics.com. Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. Pardon my outburst, ladies and gentlemen. Just gets a little hot up here. 41 seconds left in the ball game. Storm up 85-77 after a roar back from the Bison. Anthony driving against Huckel, flips up a layup. He gets fouled by Huckel going up. That'll be Huckel's first foul of the ball game, thankfully. Team's 10th foul, excuse me. 2 free throws for Mr. Anthony. Reggie Anthony receives the first free throw. No good off the back of the rim.
Student section is really trying to put a distraction on right here.
Absolutely. He is hearing it from the football team. He's getting a big distraction from Rain Belichick, shaking it down below. Second free throw is good. Lead is now 7 with 33 seconds left. This game is certainly not over. We got a foul call before the inbound. I don't know why he did that. Dawson Yates fouled CJ Rodriguez.
Could have a 30-point game right here.
CJ Rodriguez, one of the better shooters on the team at 81% for the year from the free throw line.
As I mentioned earlier, he really deserves, like, he could be an All-American this season.
I don't see why not. He's given a Herculean effort tonight, playing with four fouls and just burning people tonight. CJ Rodriguez, first free throw's around the rim and in. Dawson Yates going to take a seat. Stefan Andlkovic back in the game. Second free throw is good. Mr. Rodriguez dropping a 30-piece tonight on Harding. Reggie Anthony thinks to Andlkovic for three. Yes, sir. Lead is back to six. We got a 30-second timeout. We're going to keep it right here at SNUathletics.com. Clay, what are you seeing over these last couple seconds here by Mr. CJ Rodriguez?
I think you just got to get the ball in bounds to whoever you can. It's all the foul game right now because there's no shot clock. So just get the ball in safely, take care of it as much as you can, and wait for a foul to come.
I think you're right because the Bison players are playing them really tight up close. So I think they could just hedge them and double back court, get an easy lay-in or the foul call, and just hopefully run out the clock as well. These Storm students have stayed for this whole game, and they've earned it. This is a great ball game here. The top team in the conference going up against SNU has had their struggles these last couple games, sitting at 7-6. Only four games behind Harding and only a two-game gap between sixth place and third place.
If they get this win tonight, they will beat the top two teams in the conference here in the Sawyer Center. So
that's
definitely
right.
Something to feel accomplished about.
That's right. Other games around the GAC, Southwestern Oklahoma State outlast Arkansas Monticello 103-92. Southeastern beat Ouachita 68-56. And Ouachita Baptist up 13 with 1 minute left against Southeastern. Kuechel trying to inbound the ball. He's got LB streaking, but doesn't give it to him. Kankenpaw trying to get the ball, and he gets fouled by Jacob Gibson.
Very crucial free throws right here.
It's a smart look there by Kuechel. Because for a split second there, LB looked like he was open, but then Reggie Anthony was able to get back and cover him. Good call by Kuechel.
One make or two makes, no makes. Got to get back right here and get a stop.
Absolutely. Anton Kankenpaw, the transfer from Finland, 6'5 junior, getting his work cut out for him today. Jacob Gibson, who he was guarding, hit a couple shots over his hand, and he got discouraged, was able to come back and keep fighting on defense, and knocks down a second free throw. Reggie Anthony going to fire a three of his own over a hand. Yes, sir. Good grief. Threes have been hitting these last two possessions. Kuechel trying to find somebody. He finds Portley. Portley to Kuechel, but he gets fouled right before the pass. With 18 and a half seconds left, it's a five-point game. This game is very much not over, ladies and gentlemen.
They've hit two very clutch shots, but luckily we converted on the free throws.
Sean Portley for two. His first free throw is good. Crimson Storm as a team shooting at 66, but Sean Portley is 73% free throw shooter, knocking down both clutch free throws. 7-point game with 15 seconds left. Reggie Anthony trying to find Jacob Gibson. He's going to almost try to take a three, but it's cut off by Kankenpaw. Reggie Anthony trying to save the ball. Goes out of bounds. Back to the Crimson Storm. This game may very well be in hand, Blade.
They're probably going to try and force a turnover, but if they get in bounds, they might not even foul.
Kuechel gives it off to LB. He gives back to Kuechel, but he gets fouled before the pass. 11 seconds left, LB.
10 seconds left until Crimson Storm takes off the number one team in the conference.
LB, the Iceman, on the free throw line. With 18 points, a 5-10 shooting, and 8-10 free throws. 6 boards, 2 assists, and a block. A block that probably could have counted as 2. It was so good. LB sets, fires, and good. Storm were able to knock down free throws at the end of the ball game is a very valuable weapon here for this team and Coach Bohosh's squad.
Yeah, that's definitely
LB converts the second one.
Because some teams that miss free throws at the end and then it comes back to bite them.
Sean Portley checking Reggie Anthony. Anthony going to take a three over Huechel. He gets it with 6 seconds left. Again, this game very much not over. Huechel trying to find somebody. He's going to call a timeout before the 5 seconds is up.
Yes, and you could. This could be a whole nother story had they not made their free throws.
Man, very true, Glade. If they don't make these free throws, this could be a tie ball game, or SNU could be down at this point. We're going to take a quick break here with the timeout on the floor. Don't go anywhere. You're watching SNU basketball here at SNUathletics.com. Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. Huechel looking to inbound the ball. He's got LB Willis streaking, but he finds Kegenpaul. Nearly lost the ball, but he hangs on to it and gets fouled. 5 seconds left, up by six. Definitely a game to remember if you're an SNU student or player here, for sure, Glade.
Yeah, definitely. I don't know when the last time, like before I was a student here, last time I saw us knock off the number one team in the conference, when we were back in the NEI, is when Oakland Baptist was number one in the nation, and we beat them in overtime.
Anton Kengapaw's first free throw is off the mark. And with that, Anil Kovic comes back into the ballgame for another three-point presence. Kengapaw hits his free throw. This game is pretty much in hand. And he doesn't. He's going to hold it. Francis up the ball to Anthony. Anthony going to take a three over Rodriguez. Air ball to Willis. And this game is over. Southern Nazarene knocks off the top team in the conference. That was tied with Ouachita. They'll fall to 11-3 in the conference. SNU moves up to 8-6 in the conference, breaking the tie with Southern Arkansas for a tie for fifth. What a game today by C.J. Rodriguez and C.J. White coming through for their squad. When we come back, we'll have a breakdown of impact players' stats. And then later have an interview with head coach Adam Bohosh and our player of the game. Don't go anywhere. You're watching SNU basketball here at SNUathletics.com. Welcome back to SNUAthletics.com. Connor McKenzie alongside my partner, Glade Pittenger, in an absolute battle here. SNU was up as much as 19 in the second half, and Harding actually took the lead by two, and SNU was able to take the lead for the rest of the game and win 93-87. Glade, what are some things that stuck out to you in this ballgame?
C.J. Rodriguez just once again being an animal out there, finishing with 31 points, and he, as he went 5-6 from three, just had an outstanding night. Then a lot of other guys step in. L.B. Willis, Deshaun Portley, C.J. White all played a huge part in tonight's game. So give credit to everyone on the team who have made some crucial plays down the stretch.
Absolutely. Everybody was contributing tonight. It was a fantastic game. You did not want to miss it. You were watching tonight. What a game. You guys were just an absolute treat tonight as they took down the number one team in the conference. Not sure how long ago that's been, but I'm sure it's been a while here. SNU tops Harding 93-87 again. But some players that stuck out for Harding, they did not go away easily. SNU was up at one point by 9 points with about 30 seconds left. Then Reggie Anthony, Jacob Gibson just kept hitting threes and trying to extend the game. But Storm just kept hitting free throws to prolong the lead and be able to get the win.
Yeah, definitely. Luckily SNU was able to hold on towards the end, make some free throws as they kept hitting clutch shot after clutch shot. But we were able to hold on and pull out the victory.
Absolutely. SNU was able to get to the line 28 times to 18 for Harding. And some stats here for today. SNU started to fall off the wagon a little bit here as they had 12 turnovers in the second half and after they had 5 in the first, whereas Harding had 7 in the first and only 2 in the second half. So that's what kind of kept that game going, was turnovers and lazy passes down the stretch. But SNU was able to stick to their principles, get high hand ball closeouts, being able to chop their feet whenever they're coming out to the defenders of Harding. So they were able to do a great job sticking with their principles. Some other stats here for you guys tonight. SNU shot 30 of 51 for a total of 59%, 10 of 20 from three. Half of those, I'm sure, came from C.J. Rodriguez. Free throws were pretty great, 23 of 28 for 82%. Harding, however, they were doing not so well in the first half because they had 27 points and erupted for team free throws. So they were able to hit the free throws, just weren't able to penetrate and get to the line.
Yeah, definitely. That was definitely a true factor tonight, but just they were able to get to the line.
Nails that. 32 of 71 shooting, 10 of 30 for threes.
They made some of their free throws, but just at the end, it wasn't a factor.
Absolutely. Also, bench points. Jacob Gibson coming through with 23 bench points for his team and is able to lead that charge to bring him back within second half. He was hitting threes like crazy over Anton Kengabaugh's outstretched hand like crazy. But nonetheless, Storm get the win, 93-87. Duncan Winter, when we come back, we'll be in an interview with our player of the game, C.J. Rodriguez, erupting tonight against Harding. Duncan Winter, you're watching SNU Basketball here at SNUAthletics.com.
That's right, click.
Welcome back to SNUAthletics.com. Connor McKenzie with our man, C.J. Rodriguez, who just erupted in the first and second half, not letting this game get by. What are some things that stuck out to you, and what got you in this zone today?
Today, at Shoot Around, Coach just wanted us to move the ball, play together as a team. I told myself I was going to be a little bit more aggressive this game because what it meant to us and as a team And my teammates believed in me and, you know, found me when I was open. I thank God I just made shots.
Absolutely. 10 of 11 shooting overall. 5 of 6 from 3. 6 out of 7 from the free throw line. 5 rebounds. 8 assists and 2 blocks. 3 steals. What else can't you do, CJ? You guys absolutely put this game when you guys were in seriously behind you. You guys were able to erupt. What are some things you're looking forward to when you go against Arkansas Tech this weekend?
We're really looking forward to playing Arkansas Tech, everybody as a whole. We feel like we owed Harding because they beat us at their place, and Arkansas Tech's beat us at their place. So we're just waiting. We've been itching for this week to get a chance to play them again. So I know for sure tomorrow we're all going to be dialed in and we're all going to be ready to go. Saturday.
Absolutely. CJ Rodriguez, our player of the game with 31 points, again on 10 of 11 shooting, just an absolute stud today. We look forward to seeing them play at 1 o'clock against Arkansas Tech here in the Sawyer Center. When we come back, we'll have an interview with head coach Adam Bohosh. You'll be watching SNU basketball here at SNUathletics.com. Welcome back to SNUathletics.com. Connor McKenzie alongside Coach Adam Bohosh on a 93-87 thrilling win over Harding University, who was in first place. Now Wichita's in first place and Storm are surging up. Coach, what do you think of your team's performance today?
I thought we played good, Connor. We played hard and made a bunch of shots, and that always makes things a lot easier.
Absolutely. It was absolutely thrilling, and having a great crowd here tonight certainly amped up the energy here for you guys. So talk about what you guys thought about going down the stretch to C.J. White in the post.
Yeah, he had a couple big baskets there late, and C.J. Rodriguez had a couple big plays late, and Anton Kankapa had a big play late, and that was kind of the deal. I thought everybody who played tonight really contributed, and you mentioned it, Connor. The crowd was fantastic. The football guys were awesome tonight, and so that sure helps when we have a little bit of juice in the gym.
Absolutely. It's always good to have a little bit of juice. Hope to continue that trend here against Arkansas Tech this weekend at 1 o'clock here in the Sawyer Center. Thank you, Coach, for your time. We look forward to seeing you guys battle against Arkansas Tech this weekend. I'm Connor McKenzie signing off for SNUathletics.com.